Hello everyone, thank you for joining this presentation. I am Faisal Moteri and I'm gonna present my work with my lab mates, Dr. Konar and Dr. Zamzam, and my advisor, Professor Sideropoulos. In energy disaggregation or non-intrusive load monitoring, NELM, we are given the time series of the total power consumption of a household, and we wish to decompose it into appliance-specific series. For example, the power consumed by laptops, a stereo, a fridge, and a freezer. In this work, we propose an optimization-based energy disaggregation method that recognizes the structure of the power system distribution networks, and it also utilizes the class of set functions known as submodular functions, which find a widespread use in machine learning applications. Most of NELM studies focus on disaggregation as a feedback to consumers to improve the energy efficiency. Research studies shows a very significant saving that can be up to 15% when consumers are giving a detailed feedback. However, NELM can find many other applications as well. For example, smart home applications such as real-time monitoring, alarms, and security systems. Other applications include home categorization for targeted marketing recommendations and life coaching for elderly, for example, by anomaly detection or monitoring on and off events that indicate human activities. The rest of the presentation is structured as follows. I'll show a brief summary of the literature on energy disaggregation, then a background on power distribution systems that feed the premises. Then I'll show the formulation and algorithm of our proposed method called phased, then finally some experiments and conclusions. NELM started as a classification method where switching events in the aggregated signal are classified into the different types of appliances. Another popular approach is based on factorial hidden Markov models, where each appliance is modeled as a hidden Markov model. This class of methods is usually not scalable and requires either adding restrictive assumptions or relaxing constraints to solve the problem. Another line of work is dictionary learning or matrix and tensor factorization, where latent factors or bases are learned from appliance-specific training data. The main problem with these models is the assumption that the training and test data have a common factor. Neural networks has been recently applied and developed for energy disaggregation using both convolutional and recurrent neural networks. The main drawback lies in the amount of data needed for training. Recently, we developed a method based on combinatorial optimization that utilizes submodular functions and their special properties to derive a scalable and efficient algorithm. Our work here is also based on submodular functions. All these methods ignore the structure of power distribution systems. Our proposed method phased, on the other hand, takes the connectivity structure into account. There are two main types of power distribution systems. The first one is single phase, which is commonly used in North America for residential buildings. In single phase, the transformer takes a single phase input and provides a 240 volt output with a center tab that is connected to the ground. The voltage between the two live conductors is 240, whereas the voltage between one live conductor and the neutral is 120 volt. Light loads, such as lighting, are connected between one live conductor and the neutral to receive 120 volt, whereas heavy loads such as the fridge receive 240 by being connected between two live conductor. The second type is three phase. In a similar way, the power is delivered over three live conductors and the neutral. The voltage between any two live conductors are larger than between one live conductor and the neutral by a factor of square root of three, as shown here. The three phase is commonly used in commercial buildings in the United States and in residential buildings in Europe. The power consumption readings are often taken at every live conductor. However, the prevailing approaches in energy disaggregation literature don't consider the connectivity structure and assume that aggregated power is drawn only from a single line by summing them up. We demonstrate the connectivity structure by using the popular baseline dataset RED, which follows a single phase system, thus it has two aggregated signals. Each blue signal represents the aggregated power at one of the live conductors for the same time window. The magenta is the power consumed by electronics, which is clearly connected to the conductor on the left figure, whereas the lightning in green draws its power from the conductor in the right figure. In energy disaggregation, we are given the aggregated power Y, and we wish to estimate the appliance level series XM for M appliances. Here we plot the fridge's power, which is one example of the variables XM. This is a continuous signal, however, it can be well approximated by a quantization into few discrete values. For example, if we apply k-means with three clusters and plot the corresponding centroids at each time instant, we get the red signal. These centroids are the power levels that the fridge consumes at different states, on, off, and so on. We denote the power profile factor as mu. Now, for a given appliance M and at a given time T, X can be well approximated as the inner product of this power profile factor mu and a binary factor E with only one to select the right state. Thus, if we know the power profile factor, the problem boils down to a combinatorial optimization where the goal is to select the right state at a given time. In our previous work, we modeled the problem as follows. The disaggregation error term minimizes the difference between the aggregated power and the sum of appliances, and the constraints are just to ensure that we select one state only at a given time. The main challenge stems from the fact that this can be a very underdetermined problem. To reduce the underdeterminacy, we exploit the fact that in general appliances don't change states frequently over a short time window. And thus, we impose temporal smoothness as follows. Lambda is a regularization parameter multiplied by the inner product of the binary state selection factors of every two consecutive time instants. For example, if the appliance has two states and the appliance doesn't change state, then the product will be one. If the appliance does change state, then the product will be zero. As we refute, the electric feeder of a house consists of multiple active lines. For simplicity, let's assume we have a single phase system, thus we have two active conductors. Then we split the disaggregation term into two. Each minimizes the difference between the aggregated power at one conductor and the appliances connected to it. If the appliance is connected to line 1, then W superscript 1 and is 1, and W superscript 2 is 0, and vice versa. If in the cases where the appliance is connected between the two active lines, as in heavy loads, then W1 and 2 will be between 0 and 1 and sum up to 1. We learn these connectivity weights from training data. So this results in the final formulation in our method phased, where the first summation corresponds to the summation over the active conductors, where capital R is equal to 2 or 3 depending on the power system. Our algorithmic approach starts with recognizing that the cost function can be stated as a difference between two submodular functions. This is a special property because submodular functions are notable for exhibiting many properties similar to both convex and concave functions. However, the problem is still MP hard, and our objective is to design a high-quality approximation algorithm. We utilize a discrete optimization analog of the majorization minimization procedure. This is an iterative procedure and consists of two steps. In the majorization step, we derive an upper bound of the time smoothness term and a lower bound of the disaggregation error term. This results in a global upper bound that is equal to the original function f at the current solution and an upper bound of f at any other solution. In the second step, we minimize a modular function which plays the same role as a linear function in the continuous functions. and can be solved optimally. The overall algorithm is scalable and has a guaranteed convergence. We measure the performance using the percentage of energy diffusion, PED, from the true consumption for each appliance using this equation. Then we average over all time instances and houses using the other equation. And we compare to these baselines. DSC is a dictionary learning method. NMF is a non-negative matrix factorization based method. Sequence to point is a neural network model. PSMA is a method based on submodular functions. We use two public data sets, RED and ECHO. One represents the single phase and the other represents the three phase systems. The table shows the average of percentage of energy deviated from the true value for each appliance. The relative improvement versus all the baselines are highlighted in blue for each data set, which can be up to 61% and at least 7%. We also notice that our method significantly improves heavy load appliances. To conclude, phased recognizes and exploits the structure of the physical power networks. We formulated the problem as a difference between of submodular functions and derived an efficient algorithm with a guaranteed convergence. Phased significantly improves the disaggregation accuracy of four state-of-the-art methods. Thank you for listening, and please don't hesitate to ask questions.